get the win for the skipper. Obviously, it was pretty important tonight with such a big week and a lot of pressure on the club, and to get the win, it was amazing. We thought we were in the game the whole time. We knew we just had to get back to playing our style of footy, and we did that, and come home with the chocolates. Jakey got that point, and then Hep kicked that goal to put us 7 points clear, so we knew we had the win then. It was a great feeling, mate. It's one of the best wins I've been involved with, if not the best one for sure, yeah. Going to jump in the pool, it's pretty cold, do a bit of recovery and shut the body down, and then go up to the room and rest up, get a good night's sleep.
My run with injuries probably started in 2010. Probably don't want to sit here and list them all because we'd probably be here all day, but I'll just say a couple. I've had, a broken arm, broke my fib, obviously the pancreas, which I did halfway through 2010, and then that kept me out for the rest of that year. That was probably my worst one, which I was in intensive care, and that one shook me up a bit. I've had a bit of trouble with my ankle and foot in the past couple of years. That's the main one that's kept me out. I've had three operations on that, and I've worked really closely with the fitness staff and the physios over the past couple of years to get that right, and it's finally paying off, and I'm getting back to a level now where I can be as athletic as I used to be.
Tayte was pretty unlucky because as a kid he had a defect in the bone above the navicular, the talus, so he needed surgery early to correct that, and then that was complicated. About a year or so later he got a navicular stress fracture and had two or three operations on that to get his navicular right. Then when he tried to come back, he got stress fractures because of osteoporosis, so that held him back again. And then when he finally made it, he tore his pancreas and was in hospital intensive care for 10 days or so. Then while he'd had that, we decided to clean up his foot. So the complications of a stress fracture, osteoporosis, then rupturing his pancreas, he really wasn't on his foot probably for a year and a half off and on. And that held him right back, because in the first year, I think he played nearly every game.
Now Bateman's got it. Rioli was sold into trouble earlier.
Pears is in a bit of trouble here.
I was going back with the flight of the ball and got kneed in the stomach. And I was in a fair bit of pain and shook up a little bit, and I didn't think too much of it. I was in pain, but I played the game out, and I was in a fair bit of pain after the game, but decided to go home. Didn't get any sleep. I was tossing and turning in a lot of pain throughout the night. Decided not to call Bruce Reid. Looking back, I probably should have. Didn't want to wake the old fella up. Came in for recovery the next morning. I was pretty pale, and went straight in and seen him, and didn't look too good. So he put me in the car and drove me straight into the hospital. I think within about an hour, I was on the operating table, and after that, I was in intensive care for about a week or so, and in hospital for a couple of weeks.
It was pretty innocuous. He just got a very hard knock to the stomach. That sort of gave him a fair bit of pain, but he played on. If you rupture your pancreas, and he's leaked, but mainly into the capsule, then the digestive fluids get into your tummy and you actually digest yourself. If the pancreas juices, they're meant to be inside your stomach and inside your small bowel. If they get into the outside of your stomach, that can cause enormous troubles. Fortunately, he only had a minor leak, but no, he was a very sick boy.
Yeah, Doc Reid, he's a great man. He's someone who I'm really close with over here in Melbourne, and he's a great doctor, but he's an even better person. He's a really good fella, and I've obviously grown close to Doc just because of all the injuries I've had, and he's looked after me pretty well with a few serious injuries as well. But he's a great man, and I put all my trust in him.
Pears, he's been pretty resilient. It's a good word around our club. He's been unbelievable, really. He's one I really want to succeed if he possibly can.
My year this year, obviously I've been injured in the past, so the off-season just gone. It was a good chance for me to get a fair bit of work in because I wasn't injured, first time in a while, so no operations or anything. So I got a fair bit of work in over the break and led into pre-season. Didn't really miss a session, did the whole pre-season leading up to the games, and I haven't missed a game so far this year, and I think for me it was just more about getting back and playing consistent football, whether that be VFL, AFL. I'm just happy to be back out there playing consistent football, and I think the hard work's paid off. Yeah, I think it's just about working closely with my line coach, Sean Wellman. We've done a fair bit of work, watching my game, seeing what I can improve on, keep working on my fitness, and just all areas of my game.
It's been really good to see him just grind away, just slowly improve and be able to work on areas of his game, and you're starting to see the benefit of that now. I just think it's now about, you know, real consistency and be able to play well against the best opposition. That's where you really measure yourself on, playing against the better players. So that's something that he'll get exposed to more as the years go on. But I think if he can really shut out really good players and be a really good offensive player himself, I think that's where you'll see, you know, Tayte at his best. Definitely been frustrating for Pearsy, and I guess Cole Hardingham's the other one. I mean, we've been in a really fortunate situation where we haven't had a lot of injuries, and what that does is it creates pressure outside the team, and the guys running around in the AFL certainly know that Tayte and Hardy have been in really good form, and they need to perform at a consistent level as well, so it's really healthy. But, you know, we've had to be able to manage that as well and make sure that whether they're playing VFL or AFL, they're always working on their game, so when they do come and get the opportunity, that they're better players.
So it's healthy for the side, I suppose, when you've got blokes pushing for a spot, and there's some pretty good players playing in the VFL at the moment, which is probably a bit unlucky, but says a lot about the team and where we're going. So when you get in there, it means a lot, and for me, I love being out there and playing with, you know, my best mates at the club, which are in the senior side.
Tayte and I, we drafted at the end of 07. Tayte came from Western Australia, and I moved over from Tassie, and we struck up a bit of a relationship in our first year, and it's blossomed ever since, I guess you could say.
Yeah, Tommy's been good to me over the last couple of years. You know, with all my injuries and stuff, he stuck by me, and it's always good to have close mates. I've got a lot of close mates. It's not just Tommy at the club, but yeah, it's good to just have those guys just to get away from the footy club and go and hang out and take your mind off, you know, training and that sort of thing.
Yeah, Pez has had a tough run through injury. You don't wish that upon anyone, and Tayte's the kind of guy, he's a very resilient character, and he's had to fight his way through a lot of injuries. I guess it's just being there for him to talk to, go and have a beer with if he needs to have a beer with someone. Me and him are pretty good at that, so we do that occasionally, but yeah, just being there for him as a mate, I guess, is the main thing.
Hills is another bloke who I'm close with at the club. You know, I look up to Hills. He's the leader of the group, and he's probably been similar to me in the way he's had a couple of injuries. It's probably more about the way he attacks the football. He's really hard at it, and he's a couple of times he gets injured because of that. So I admire that about his football, though, and you wouldn't change that. But yeah, he's really good to me. Also, he's always very caring. Hills is a really caring guy, and he looks after you when you get injured and stuff.
Obviously, the pancreas issue put him back. Lost about 10 kilos, so that in itself, to put that weight back on, is pretty tough. Obviously, he's had a lot of issues with his feet, and I think that made it even harder because he wasn't able to run, and he spent a lot of time in the pool, a lot of time on the bike, a lot of time, I suppose, away from the boys, which makes it even harder. He's worked so hard, and he's got himself in such good shape, and to see him back playing now is it's pretty amazing. He's one of those players that you love running out alongside, and I know how much Tayte means to all the boys, and the boys are wrapped for him to be playing senior footy again.
You know, he's got some real influence amongst his teammates because they do gravitate towards him as well. I'm not sure if he understands how much influence he does have on his teammates, but I think he's certainly starting to recognise that, and that's going to make him a better player, knowing that he can't just influence himself, but he can make people around him better as well.
My contract is out at the end of this year, so for me, this year has been pretty important, and that's why I was lucky that I had no injuries really in the off season. I could get a fair bit of work in, and I've worked really hard to try and get back to a level where, you know, I can play AFL football, and I think I've done that. Hopefully, the clubs realise the hard work that I've put in, and if I can keep playing consistent football, like I said, whether that be AFL or VFL level, hopefully the club realises that and gives me another contract.